well, it is a Thursday night and it is quite a summery night. We've had a lot of hot weather and I've been a little bit under the weather and focusing very much on getting fit and healthy for summer as well. So I thought, hey, I want to share with you tonight something that I would throw together on an average night on my own if I'm trying to be good and healthy. Because let's face it, it is spring down here and down under. It's been spring carnival season. We're going into Christmas. It's the happy season. We need to make the most of the nights where we can be good. And look, I don't like to use the D word, but hey, we all need to be conscious of what we're eating. And, you know, certainly I need to lose just a few more kilos. So what I wanted to share with you is one of my favorite spring evenings. Really quick, easy and simple. You look at this and go, this is what you eat for lunch. And yes, certainly it is what you eat for lunch. But you know what? You can also have for lunch what you have for dinner. It's about what you've eaten for the rest of the day. So look, I've had a fairly large lunch today, so I'm just going for something light. Wanted to share it with you guys. I like to kick it off with a bit of the crust layer. I'm a fan of carbohydrates, and I'm not scared to talk about carbohydrates. I'm not scared to like carbohydrates. I'm also not scared to eat them at night. If you know your body type and you know what type of carbohydrates you're eating and you're balancing it with your input and your output, just remember, and I guess this is for those of you who don't know, I do have a health background. After many years of working in the health field, I can say to you, don't be too scared of carbohydrates as a general. You just need to be really cautious about what you're eating and most importantly, get to know your body type so you know what you need. For example, for me, if I don't have the right number of carbohydrates throughout the day, I get fatigued the next day. Same with your protein levels, same with all of the essential foods. So you don't want to completely eradicate anything, but balance what you're eating. So going for a simple crust tonight, something that's not too high in fat, light, crispy, I enjoy them. I've also chosen to go for a light cream tea spread on this. You can get really delicious low-fat spreads these days, guys. Use them, cottage cheese, Philly, anything like that. And then add it on top for a little bit of mushiness and texture. My favorite thing in the world, it is the avocado. Before you go, ew, particularly guys who go, ew, avocado. Probably one of the greatest foods you can ever work with. Now, I am a person who struggles to eat seafood, so I've been making an effort to increase my omega-3 consumption, which is, of course, a very essential oil that you should have and great for memory and all sorts of things, very vital. I do struggle, so I do tend to go for my tin tuna because I'm not great at eating fish, particularly if you're on your own. Before you turn up your nose, it can be quite tasty, particularly with the available marinated flavors these days. I highly recommend it, so there you go. So I just put a little bit of tuna on top of my crust kit here. It's very hard for you guys to see because I don't have the best camera angles. I then like to lay it up with a little bit of tomato there. Now, one of the things that I learned in Europe, and I might be wrong for all of the European connoisseurs that are rolling their eyes, a little bit of salt on top of your tomato tends to pull out the flavors. So if you're looking at those beautiful marinated tomato salads, they tend to have either a vinegar or a salt on top of them. I love it. Little sprinkle of salt on top. A little bit of red onion. I'm a massive, massive fan of red onion. To me, it is just divine. It brings out all the yumminess, but probably not the best thing to have if you're like having a first date because things could get a bit awkward, that and the old garlic. And then I am a big fan also of my mixed lettuce leaves. So I'd put those on there like that. A delicious, tasty, healthy snack. I'd have something like 3 or 4 of these for dinner, 5 if I'm really hungry. You'd be surprised. Wash down with a piece of fruit. This can be a complete dinner for you and you really don't need anything else. But you probably do want to wash it down with plenty of this. Okay, not really. The truth is this is now my water bottle, so it's plenty of fresh water from the fridge to keep you well hydrated. Because that is certainly what you need in the heat of summer. That's weird tasting my way. It's a pleasure doing healthy eating with you guys. Speak to you later.